Going to take a little first look today at Dead Light and Other Dark Turns, Two Unsettling Encounters on the Road for Call of Cthulhu. I believe this is all for the 7th edition. We have some authors here. Easier to read. So the two scenarios in this are Dead Light and Saturnine Chalice. With the rise of the automobile in the 1920s, people were no longer tied to the railways as a means of getting to distant locations. So these scenarios are both, yes, for the 7th edition, are both sort of meant, from what I can understand, are meant to be kind of plugged in if you're doing some travel. I think they can be run just and on their own as a one-shot, but that they can be used if you're doing some travel between one location or another. You can sort of plug these in. That's my understanding on this. And they are, yeah, I think, oh, okay. Dead Light, I knew, was an older scenario, and I think Seth Gorkowski has reviewed it, and some other folks have talked about it. Saturnine Chalice apparently is new to this. I did not realize that. I thought they actually were both revamps of older stories. There could be spoilers in the images that I flip through. I don't know. I'm just going to do a quick flip through of these. I do like that's some seriously creepy art. So I ended up picking this up because I possibly, stupidly, I am giving serious thought to trying my hand at running Masks of Nyarlathotep at some point. It's been bouncing around the back of my head for a long time, frankly, since well before the 7th edition version of it was even talked about, much less released. I used to have the complete book that had been released many, many, many years ago. It's just always been one of those campaigns, you know, you hear about, you hear the stories, if you're a Call of Cthulhu fan, certainly if you're a keeper, people talk about running it and talk about their sort of war stories of running it. So it's always been there as a book that I've been interested in trying my hand at, and I'd like to try to run the campaign, but it is so incredibly daunting. It is just such a beast. And I think about people talking about how long their campaigns ran, and a lot of folks talk about, you know, a year at the absolute least, and a lot of folks say a year and a half, 2 years, possibly even a little more. Can I do that? Can I sustain for that long? Can I maintain a group for that long? Do I have players who are willing to invest 2 years of possibly gaming? You know, I'm not a kid anymore. I used to game multiple times a week and certainly once a week for various games that I was involved in. These days, I'm lucky. It takes me months to get something put together. So can I get a group of people who can make it, you know, every week or every other week at the most for the next couple of years? I don't know. And if I run it, I want to run it face-to-face, so I don't know. But anyway, I know there's a lot of travel in it. I like the idea of being able to sort of plug in some scenarios to throw things for a loop, to give folks something new to check into. You know, maybe I link it in. Maybe I find some way to make it actually officially tie in, really link into what they're researching. Maybe not. Maybe it's just a one-off. I don't know. I love props. And I think that's part of my problem is I really want to do Call of Cthulhu face-to-face because I love the props. I don't feel like there's the same satisfaction when you're gaming online. If people get that satisfaction, then great, good for them. I do not. So I'm fascinated by a lot of the props that are in this. There's a lot of props for two relatively short scenarios. So, cool. Credits for some folks. Yeah. Gateways to Terror, Molson. You know, I have run Call of Cthulhu multiple times over the years, but I feel like a novice, especially with 7th edition being out, and I took a 10-plus year break from the hobby, so I really feel, in a lot of ways, like a beginner again. I'm learning this whole process again, so some easier bite-size chunks to take, as well as stuff like, get back to it, which apparently I can't. But Gateways to Terror, I believe, is, I think this is one that's intended for, ideal for beginners and experienced players and keepers alike. Okay. So it's like short scenarios. So, anyway, Deadlights, you know, Call of Cthulhu, Chaosium, they keep kicking it out of the park. Kicking it out of the park, knocking it out of the park. I don't know my sports metaphors. They're doing good work. I really want to get myself using this stuff more regularly, and I'm hoping to have like a little arsenal of these sort of scenarios that I can just pop in where I need them. I know there's one in Pulp Cthulhu about a steamer ship going across the Pacific that I'm definitely, holding in my back pocket to plug into either Masks of Nyarlathotep, or if I do get going and do something like Children of Fear or something like that. I like the idea of like traveling across there. I know there were some scenarios made for airplanes, I think, at one time or other, or perhaps there was an old, I know there was an old supplement about various means of transportation and scenarios wrapped around them. And I like that idea. I don't think I'm going to go track that book down. Anyhow, this is just taking a quick look. Deadlights. Hopefully we'll get some Call of Cthulhu going on again sometime. Maybe in this year. We'll see. Have you run this? Have you run either of these scenarios? You had a good time, bad time? Have you played in these scenarios? Good time, bad time again? I feel like a character certainly will have a bad time, but hopefully the players had a good one. It for me today. The usual YouTube blah blah. Until next time, take care.